Okay, this will probably be jerky as all heck here, because I'm gonna try and hold the camera while I also try to grab lumber. But this is my setup for cutting boards down quickly. So I've got a stop down here that I have permanently fixed into the table, and this allows me to go ahead and make a cut, set it off to the side. Slide it over to the stop again. Make a cut, set it off to the side. Slide the board down. Now, this will be the part that is the real time saver, because on an 8-footer, you can get 3 of one cut size and 2 of the other and switch it back and forth so that you get perfect amounts. So all I have is this little board that I can drop in at any time and go ahead and make another cut. I knew it was going to catch on that knot some. And to eliminate some knots, I can just flip that board around like that. Cut the rest of the junk off. So, you're probably like, why is that all built up weird? Why don't you just have a single piece of wood? So I actually have these little triangle shapes underneath, because in the past, I would constantly have sawdust building up against my board. So I have that actually up in the air, suspended up in the air, and it's got a whole bunch of these underneath. So as sawdust builds up, it just keeps getting pushed underneath and pushed out the backside. And when I want to drop this in, it too is elevated in the air, and sawdust can go around those triangles and filter down. You were like, why don't you just clean it off and stuff? I would, over and over and over again. And I'd have friends here cleaning, or I should say cutting boards and then supposedly cleaning. And when you go to assemble your boxes later and you get to box number like 150, you start noticing that they aren't perfect anymore. People got lazy, myself included probably, and the sawdust would build up. And instead of your boxes being 16 1/4 inches for the faces and 19 7/8 for the sides, you would start losing an 1/8 inch or something because of the sawdust building up on the thing. So anyhow, this allows me to just take a board, cut, 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 take a board, cut, 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 and everything gets out of my way, and I'm able to drop in and pull out my guides as I need to. This also is handy because it allows me to quickly change back and forth so I can avoid the knots in the wood, so that they won't be on the finger joints that I'll put later on. Like here, you really don't want knots on the finger joints. It makes them really weak, so we avoid that at all cost. Anyhow, that's my setup as quickly as I can show it.